Welcome to the Simply Incredible Podcast. I am Daryl, a.k.a. The D, and with me is Jeff Soares.
Hey, what's up, Daryl?
What's going on, my friend? For those who don't know, Jeff is also a YouTube man. Speak up. Don't be bashful. We don't
mind. It's my first time doing a podcast, but yes, I have my own YouTube channel. It's called Jeff Soares. It's mainly about horror, Funko Pops, Funko products, and yeah, that's about it.
So how'd you get started with those?
My friend Anthony, we went to Newbury Comics a few months back, and he showed me these Funko Pops, and I was looking for some horror figures, and I seen that they had a Freddy Funko Pop. I'm like, oh, all right. So I bought that one, and then I just needed to get all the other horror pops, and then from there,
yep,
it just blew up.
Yeah, that was like with me. It started with Batman and Harley Quinn, and next thing you know, I got like a wall, and then like a whole nother room is just jam packed.
Right? It's crazy, man.
So Newbury, I've heard a lot about Newbury. I'm in Lynchburg, Virginia, and I've heard about Newbury. Is that really big, or is it just multiple locations, or what?
There's a few locations. I can get to about three of them.
That's awesome.
That's close by. It's an awesome store, you know? It's got tons of Funko Pops, horror figures, sci-fi, comics. You know, it's awesome store.
So is it like more comic books, or like more of the collectibles?
A few years ago, it was a lot about just comics and music. You know,
music.
Now it's like almost like a clothing store, but they do still have comics, but it's a smaller selection of comics now. And, I thought Newbury Comics was worldwide, but I guess not, right?
Well, at least not around here anywhere, but in Lynchburg, it's pretty small. Like I said, all I've ever heard has been up in like the Connecticut area, somewhere up there. And you're from, Cambridge?
Yeah, Cambridge,
Mass?
Just outside of Boston.
Is that, oh, Beantown.
Oh, yeah.
So, how about that 1986 World Series? See, I'm a Mets fan, so there you go. Bill Buckner. And I'm sorry. So, horror. Yeah, that's actually how I became aware of your page. Chucky.
Chucky, yeah.
Is that your fave?
He is my all-time favorite horror character.
You know, it's one thing that I've never figured out. They had a DVD collection, but it did not include the first one. I never could understand that. And if you look around, it's hard to find anything with that first Chucky.
Yeah, I've always looked for the box sets, and I could never find the first Child's Play.
And I never could figure that out.
But I did find one on Amazon, and it was like about $30, and it comes with all the movies.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that on DVD or Blu-ray?
It's DVD.
That's awesome, because I've never seen one. Because I remember when they first come out with a collection, I used to go to Best Buy. And they did not have that. I know you can't tell us, but I used to have a lot longer hair. You know, a nice 1980s mullet rocking. And one of my nurses, she used to go, you know, you look like Chucky. I was like, that's horrible. It's like horribly awesome.
So what made you choose to cut the hair off?
I got old. in all honesty, it was I do mixed martial arts. And I used to do jiu-jitsu, and that's grappling. And when you're on your back and you have long hair, it gets caught under you. And it's either you just stay there, or when you try to move, some of your hair gets kind of ripped out.
Oh,
so, yeah,
that must hurt.
Yeah, so it was time to cut the hair. As we used to call it, the French moulet. It wasn't a mullet, it was a moulet.
That's funny, because I used to have long hair as well.
Yeah.
It went up to my shoulders.
Well, now you got the beard down.
What's that?
See, now you're rocking the beard.
Yeah. I had the long hair and a long beard. And I decided to cut it just to change.
Mm-hmm.
But I miss my long hair a lot.
I do miss mine, but as I've gotten older, it quit growing in some places, so it just looks stupid. One of my friends has a mohawk, and where I'm kind of thinning, I told her it wouldn't look like, for me, like a mohawk, it looked like Morse code. It's like little here, nothing, little here, nothing, little here, nothing.
That's funny.
So what are your favorite pops besides the horror?
My favorite pops.
Mm-hmm.
I'm an 80s guy.
Mm-hmm. You know. Yeah, me too.
So I'm always looking for like the 80s style pops.
Mm-hmm.
But my favorite one was actually one that my brother gave me for Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
It's a Sloth from the Goonies.
Oh yeah, I remember seeing that. Was that the, which one was that? That had the Superman shirt on?
Yes, the Comic-Con exclusive. Yep.
Yeah, that's one I would love to have. I've got the rest of the Goonies, but I have not found the regular one or the variant on that one.
Gosh. See, I was lucky because he was trying to get me the whole set.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then when he got it in the mail, was like, I'm not exactly sure what this is, but I was trying to get you the whole set
mm-hmm.
of the Goonies, and I opened it. I'm like, this is awesome.
That is awesome.
You know?
So did you get the whole series of them or just that one?
Just that one.
See, I know it locally. Do y'all have FYE up there?
We used to have FYE like 5-6 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah. The closest one's about 40-50 minutes away.
Wow. Yeah. One of my friends lives in Roanoke, Virginia. That's about an hour from here. And theirs got taken out about that same time. And mm-hmm. we still have ours, and they've had a few of the Goonies figures. So, I'll see if I can find you some of them. Let's see.
Yeah, I mean, like, when it comes to Funko Pops, there aren't many Pops that I would want to complete the series, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I just go for, like, the ones that I really like.
Yeah.
You know?
So, what do you think about the box openings? Because I know you do some, I do some, and some are great, some are horrible.
With the taking the pop out of the box?
No, like the crates. Like the Collector's Core, Smuggler's Bounty, what else we get? Nerd Block.
I like them.
Hmm?
It's expensive to get them all.
Yes.
But I find that a lot of sub boxes sometimes they don't really take care of the Funko Pops.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know? And I've probably had one or two problems with that. And there's one sub box I really wanted was the pop in the box.
Yeah.
But I've seen so many videos, the pops are just damaged. You mm-hmm. know, and I keep my pops in the box. You know, and it's very important for me to have a mint pop box. So, you know, pop in the box, you know, giving us damaged boxes.
Yeah.
Not good.
Yeah, that's exactly how I am with my stuff. So I've really, really narrowed down the ones I get too. And me and you both found this out, getting some of the quote Comic-Con boxes.
Yeah.
Like you got the Chicago one, didn't you? And then you got the, what was it called? Emerald City.
Yes.
And I think me and you were both highly disappointed with that.
I mean, it's, when I got the Chicago Comic-Con box, you know, I wish I would have known what's inside before I ordered the Emerald City.
Yeah.
Because mm-hmm. it always takes some time from Canada to come here.
Yeah.
And if I knew that it was going to be horrible, I would never order the Emerald City.
Yeah.
But it just seems like a regular Nerd Block box.
Yeah.
No, there's nothing exclusive. Well, they say that this shirt.
Yeah, the Spider-Gwen shirt, yeah.
But I mean, I want, you know, an exclusive pop or something, you know?
I mean, they even had, in mine had two comics. Yours had one.
Yeah.
And what I actually believe is one of them that I got was the same one that you got in the Chicago box.
The Vader down?
Yeah. I had two different variants on the Vader down. in mind, I was like, why are they giving people two of the same comic? That makes no sense.
You know, I emailed him, like, I'm missing a comic book.
Mm-hmm.
And they say, you know, take a picture of what you got, and we'll go from there.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, it's... Somebody told me that some people got two comics, some people got one, and some magnets.
I got magnets, too. That set of four magnets, yeah.
All right.
Yeah, the bombshells.
Yeah. So, yeah, see, I'm going to be on top of Nerd Block, because
mm-hmm.
those Comic-Con boxes, they're like, what, like 40 bucks?
Yeah, they're 40 bucks, and you had $10 shipping on top of that.
Yeah, so, like, I definitely want my second comic book.
Exactly. I mean, that's ridiculous. I mean,
it is.
I mean, it's supposed to be, like you said, exclusive to, supposed to be Emerald City yep. Comics. And we got, supposedly, a t-shirt that I believe we could find that t-shirt online somewhere.
Oh, definitely, yeah.
I mean, it's just the cover of the Spider-Gwen comics. I'm sure it's out there. And... Huh. And the Vader Down comic was, one of them was Vienna Comic Con, and I can't remember what the other one was. But to me, they
have it here, I think. This one just says.
Nerd Block.
Comic Block.
Comic Block. That's what it was.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I was like, man, me and you both, we felt ripped off on that deal.
Yeah, I mean, the only thing that I liked was during checkout,
mm-hmm.
when you order the boxes, you can add a grab box.
Yeah.
You know, and it's like 10 bucks.
Mm-hmm.
So I did that, and I got a lot of great items.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that box was more exciting than the Comic-Con box.
Yeah. But they tagged on, I was going to get that as well, but then I saw that they tagged on another $10 shipping on that one, too. So I was like, yeah, I'm not paying another $10 shipping on it. And I, like, honestly, like you said, if I had known what the Chicago box was in that before I ordered the other one, I wouldn't have ordered it.
Right.
I mean, I tell you what, I knew they lost a lot of customers on that deal.
Yeah, I mean, I must have seen 10, 15 videos
mm-hmm.
on YouTube. Some people really loved it,
mm-hmm.
but a lot of them were just, you know, hating it.
Yeah.
Horrible. I mean, I am comfortable to say that I'm never going back to Nerd Block.
Is he right?
Because I was getting the Horror Block.
Yeah.
And even with the Horror Block, now it's like in-house items, and they you know, they call it exclusive items, but they're cheap.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, this is not worth, you know, money, so it's, nah.
Yeah, see, I still have my subscription to the Nerd Block Classic, and honestly, if this next one's no good, then I'm gonna be getting rid of that one too. It stinks, to be quite honest. It's brutal what they've done. And honestly, I thought they were in New York, and I sent them a message like, why is it taking so long to ship? And they said, well, when it crosses the border, that's when they will pick it up. The shipping one, yeah. I mean, with the tracking. I was like, across the border? What, New York is a border to Pennsylvania? What in the world? I had no idea. Like, that's crazy. But I will say this. This you had this too, didn't you? The metal bat thing?
Yes, that is awesome.
I love this thing. I mean, which company was it that had this?
Bambox.
Bambox, that's right. Because they had that, and they had that coin with... Punisher on one side and Daredevil on the other.
Daredevil on the other, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, this is quality. It's not a cheap plastic. I mean, I love that.
Oh, that's it. It's a very heavy battering.
Yeah.
You know, and I was just wondering, like, what am I going to do with this? You know, I need to put it on the wall or something.
Mm-hmm. I'm actually going to put it, like, right up here behind me somewhere, like on one of these right here. I don't know if you can see that. Yeah, like something like that. Yeah. Put it back there somewhere.
Mine's actually on my TV stand.
Mm-hmm.
And I use some that 3M tape.
Yeah.
You know, and it sticks fine. It did fall once because it's so damn heavy.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's got to put it back on there, and it's on it now.
That's awesome. So, did you ever find any more of the Walgreens Arkham minis?
No.
I haven't seen, in Lynchburg, there's four around here. I've not seen a single one. Four Walgreens, not a single box anywhere.
I went to so many Walgreens. Mm-hmm. I wasted so much gas.
Yep.
Because I drive a huge F-250.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so it's a gas guzzler, and I've been to so many Walgreens and nothing.
Yeah.
It's the same stuff. It's that stuff from Frozen.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, and they still have Pops from Duck Dynasty.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Wow.
Because ours recently got added some of the Gotham figures, the Pop vinyls.
Oh, really?
Like Harvey Bullock and who else was in it? I think Catwoman. They might have had Catwoman there, too. Selena Kyle's with that. I'll call her on the show. But like you say, everyone I've ever been to has Frozen Pops.
Yep.
And I they need to put those things on sale to get rid of them. They just gonna sit there forever.
Yeah, I mean, I've seen Pops there that's been sitting there for a long, long time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and same with Target.
Yeah.
You know, the closest Target near me. What they've done was they got the Pops, and they placed those heavy plastics on the Pop box.
Mm-hmm.
So they can hang them.
Yeah.
And I'm like, that just ruins the box.
Yeah.
Nobody's going to buy them.
See, mine right here, they don't do that. They put them on shelves, so they don't hang them up. But I will say this. There's a ton of the exclusive, the Cars. Was it Ramon? Ramon from the Cars? Roddy Piper, there's still a ton of those here too.
Yeah, I went to one that was about 3-4 miles away.
Mm-hmm.
And I did see tons of that Star Wars with the blood hand.
Oh, really?
Yeah, there was about like probably 10 of them.
Yeah, that hadn't made it down here yet. If it has, I haven't seen it yet. Because that's one I actually do want to find. So
it's an awesome pop.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Finn before he knew any better. That's one thing about that movie I never figured out. It's like all these stormtroopers, and just one random one gets through. It's like,
yeah,
what happened there? That made no sense. There needs to be a backstory of how that happened, how he made it through the stormtrooper academy. So what? Hang on. Let's talk some horror movies. Like, what are your favorites? I mean, obviously, Child's Play, but Friday the 13th, Nightmare,
on Elm Street. Yeah, I mean, when I want to watch horror movies, I stick with, you know, my old school horror movies, like, you know, Jason Voorhees,
mm-hmm.
Freddy Krueger, you know, Mike Myers.
Yeah.
Like, those movies, they never get old.
Yep.
You know, I can watch them 100 times. Trick or Treat.
Oh, that's one I haven't seen in a long, long time.
And I think there's actually another one called Trick or Treat, but it's with Ozzy Osbourne.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you've seen that one.
I have not seen that. I didn't even hear about that.
Yeah, it's has Ozzy Osbourne, and there's like some, I don't know, some weird, crazy, heavy rocker metal dude.
Mm-hmm.
And he's out to kill people.
I'm writing this down so I can check it out later on.
Yeah, I got the DVD somewhere here.
Mm-hmm. That's one I never even knew that he was in any movies.
The demon comes out when you play his music.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then they have to stop a radio station, you know, from them not playing his music, or else things will get. You know, things will go crazy.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
I didn't even think about that. Like I said, I never even heard about that. I'm definitely going to see if I can find that. Love some Ozzy, but half the time I can't understand what he's saying.
Yeah.
I never figured that out, how he can sing so great, but yet he can't talk.
I know, right? That's it's very strange.
It's, I mean,
I've seen Ozzy live so many times.
Huh?
And once he starts talking, I'm like, what?
It's like Bob Dylan.
And then the music goes, I'm like, all right.
Like, Bob Dylan's like, I don't know what you're saying, but your music is awesome. Wow, Bob Dylan. I just went old school there. So are you a Red Sox fan up there? A Patriots fan? Or just, no?
I'm not a huge sports fan.
Mm-hmm.
I will watch baseball if I'm with some friends and we go out to a bar or something.
Yeah.
I do like hockey.
I love me some hockey. Well, no, I like the hockey fights.
Yeah. Yeah, that's where I like a lot. But, you know, our Boston Bruins, we haven't been doing so well.
Yeah,
I'm not really too big into sports, just wrestling.
Ah, there we go. Now we can discuss WrestleMania. Yeah. What did you think?
You know, I don't have a TV. I mean, my TV that I use is my computer screen.
Uh-huh.
So I don't have a cable box, so I can't watch Raw.
Oh.
You know, but I do read about it.
Mm-hmm.
And when I heard Shane McMahon is back and he's going to be fighting The Undertaker.
Mm-hmm.
Like, okay, I have to go and get back to WWE Network.
Yeah.
Because I have to watch this, you know, and they give you 1 month free.
Yeah.
You know, and I don't think I'm going to cancel it because there's so many awesome pay-per-view, so many old school stuff
mm-hmm.
on that network. But that WrestleMania match
mm-hmm.
with Shane.
Yeah.
You know, when I first saw it, he has the biggest balls
yeah.
that I've ever seen. Just to climb up there and, like, jump off and yeah. having your wife and kids on ringside.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's insane.
Yeah, that was the first thing I thought. When he would start climbing up, I was like, stop, Shane. Shane, stop. Stop. Your family's, yeah. like, right there at ringside. Stop, Shane. But I noticed you did put that video up where there was an air mat under the table.
Yes.
But still.
I was reading up some stories saying that Shane's fall versus Mankind's fall.
Yeah.
You know, and I wanted to make sure that people know that, like, you can't bring up Shane McMahon and Mankind at, you know, with the Hell in the Cell. You know, so I watched it very carefully, and you can see that there's a huge airbag
yeah.
underneath that table. You know, and while Shane is climbing, that airbag, you know, is lifting that table very, very slightly, you know, and
mm-hmm.
yeah, that's something you shouldn't do.
Yeah.
Because you have fans at ringside, and they see this huge bag.
Yeah.
It's like, wow, like, that was a big fail.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm still like, you know, if I was up there, I'm like, yeah, I don't think I'm doing it, even though there's an airbag. That was a
same
long
here.
Fall.
It's like, you can miss it, you uh-huh. know. You can hit the corner mm-hmm. of that table.
Yeah.
And your back will be gone. I mean, it's something that a lot of wrestlers backstage would never do.
Yeah.
You know, and I don't know why he did it. He doesn't have to do it.
Yeah.
You know, it's just insane seeing somebody that's not a wrestler, you know, go up there and just jump off.
Mm-hmm. Oh, dude, he had some crazy matches back when he was there. Do you remember one?
Yeah.
I can't remember what pay-per-view it was. It was him with Kurt Angle. And they had some glass with, like, the logo of whatever pay-per-view it was. And Kurt was, like, just throwing him through the glass. And one of them wouldn't break.
Yeah.
He threw him into that glass like four times. It's like, that was brutal.
He's been in so many insane matches.
Mm-hmm.
And that's one of the crazy matches he's been in. And the other one was with Steve Blackman.
Yeah.
Where he was climbing up on the Titantron.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And he just fell. I mean, wow, that's...
Yeah.
Talk about hardcore, you know?
Blackman, I forgot about him. It's been a long time since I heard that name. I was in, they had the King of the Ring in Greensboro 1 year. It was Austin versus Shane and Vince. And they had ladders and stuff, and they were throwing Stone Cold was throwing both of them through ladders. Man, that was a rough match. It's like, especially, I mean, you got to think Vince at the time. See, this is probably 20 years ago, so he was in his 50s at the time, I'm sure, or right around that. And Shane was probably in his early 20s. I was like, man, you're throwing a billionaire through a ladder. So. Man, those guys. And
see, that's what made wrestling awesome.
Yeah.
You know, that Attitude Era, that you can, like, give the boss a middle finger.
Mm-hmm.
You can beat up your boss, and then you can fight your boss and put him through a table. And, like, wow, that's...
Yeah, you can drive...
That was awesome.
Yeah, Stone Cold could drive a beer truck down to the ring and spray him down with beer.
Yeah.
And they said, I don't know if you read this, that they said that actually had... The first part of that hose actually had beer in it. And then it went to water. So they actually won. So the crowd would know, wait, they smell beer getting poured on the boss. That was hilarious back then.
Oh, yeah, man. I mean, if it was all beer, I think there would be lots of lawsuits.
Because mm-hmm.
all the kids getting wet mm-hmm. with Budweiser. Yeah, you know?
Good old Steve Weiser.
Yep.
Did you, you say you did watch Mania?
I did, yeah.
So did you, gosh, what other match did you like in that?
I was also excited for the Brock Lesnar match.
Mm-hmm.
But who did he fight again? Because I
haven't
been watching. Yeah, there we go.
Dean Ambrose. Yep.
And it was suplex after suplex after suplex.
Yep.
It was boring. You know, they could have done a better job. You know, because I've heard that's going to be an awesome street fight. So, some hardcore weapons.
Mm-hmm.
He took out a chainsaw like he was going to use it.
Yeah.
You know?
He had trouble starting it.
Yeah. When I seen that chainsaw, it just reminded me of Terry Funk.
Yep. That's where he got it.
Yeah.
Terry Funk gave it to him, and I think Mankind gave him the bat with the barbed wire on it.
Mm-hmm.
And, well, you know, the thing of it is, they got the PG era, so they really can't do much. With that, like those kind of matches, you know, they like bleeding. They pretty much stop bleeding now.
No, it's pay per view. It's WrestleMania. It's their Super Bowl.
Yeah.
No, they should be able to go all out.
Yeah, I agree.
You know, but that match they could have done a lot better.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I didn't like it at all.
You watch NXT now?
I've never watched an. I read about it because
mm-hmm.
I have a lot of friends on Facebook who are fans.
Mm-hmm. I'm one of them.
Always posting stuff,
mm-hmm.
so I do read about it.
Yeah, I love NXT. The only thing I'm going to hate is they're starting to call a lot of the guys that I like up to the big show now, and they're gonna kill their characters, and I hate that.
Yeah, I've seen. A lot of guys, you know, from NXT go into the WWE, and then all of a sudden they just disappear.
Yeah.
Like it's too fast.
Yeah.
You know, and they're great wrestlers. Like he's not from NXT. That guy that won Tough Enough.
I think
it was Tough Enough.
This year.
I think it was a few years ago when. When Austin was hosting.
Oh, yeah, that guy, I know who you're talking about. And that guy, I think he quit, I believe.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Because Austin just hosted 1 year, right?
I believe so, yeah.
Yeah. And I remember that guy, he was a really big, tall dude. But yeah. They said he just, I don't know, at some point, just like, I don't want to do it anymore. I remember one of the first years they had it, was that kid's name, Maven.
Maven, yeah.
Yeah, he was around for a little while, and then he just vanished. I don't know what happened with him.
You know, I do see a lot of wrestlers. Mm-hmm. They come down to Mass.
Mm-hmm.
They have this Boston wrestling,
mm-hmm.
and he's smaller wrestling. And just last Saturday, Sting was here.
Really?
It's about an hour away from where I live.
Mm-hmm.
And I wanted to go, but, you know, I found out too soon. You know, but a lot of these wrestlers, like, I think Maven is probably still wrestling, but
mm-hmm.
he's probably getting paid $20 to $50 to wrestle one yeah. match,
mm-hmm.
you know? So it's just very sad because, like, a lot of these wrestlers, they deserve a second chance.
Yeah. You know? And some of the guys I see and it seems like they're at WWE, but you never see them. Like, like Jack Swagger. You see him once every blue moon. He gets a little push, and then he's back to background again. Heath Slater's another one. Yeah, you see him there, then he vanishes.
You know, I forgot about him until I started watching a show on the WWE Network. What's it called? Screwed?
Or something? Gosh, that's I know what you're talking about. That's not the name of it, but I know what you're talking about.
It's like Punked or
yeah, like something. Yeah, they play into practical jokes on each other. Yeah. Swerved.
Yeah, Swerved, that's go. It. And he's like probably on there like on every episode.
Yeah.
You know? That is pretty funny though.
Yeah. I mean,
they've been, you know, using tasers.
The one that got me was what's his name? The guy from the New Day, Xavier Woods, he put that powder in Kofi Kingston's face.
I know that hurt.
That was a lot of powder.
Yeah.
I was like, good grace, you might have blinded the man.
He didn't shoot him from, like, across the room. He was
right in his face.
Wow.
Like, being at home watching, it's hilarious. Being in that situation would not be funny.
No.
You know, this actually reminds me of something because Hornswoggle was on that show, and he actually did a remake of The Leprechaun.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Instead of getting Warwick Davis, they got Hornswoggle because I think it was done with a WWE production. And that's not cool.
I think I know what you're talking about now.
It's like, wow.
Is that movie out yet?
I would assume so, because it's been a couple years.
Huh, I forgot all about that. I have not. Wow, yeah. I'm going to have to check that out.
Let's see. I'm going to. I can't find it somewhere. Do, 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 do. So, who's your favorite wrestlers?
When I first started watching. It would have to be Shawn Michaels.
Mm-hmm.
And Shawn Michaels, Bret Hart. Actually, I like Bret Hart a lot. You know? Mm-hmm. He was probably one of my favorite wrestlers when I first started watching wrestling. And then Stone Cold came. And it was over. Yeah. But I also did watch a lot of ECW.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
You know, and... it was very difficult because, ECW, at that time, it was way better than WWE.
Yeah.
I mean, those hardcore matches.
Yeah, some of those guys were brutal.
Yeah. And Stone Cold was actually in ECW.
Yeah, right after he got fired from WCW.
Yep.
And I mean, he dropped some great promos in that area.
Did he
even wrestle there?
He wrestled a few times, yeah.
Because I knew he was there, and the reason he got fired from WCW because he was hurt, so that's why I didn't even remember he did anything. By the way, it's called Leprechaun Origins. It was in 2014. Rotten Tomatoes gave it 10% out of 100. IMDb has 3.3 out of 10. IGN has 0.9 out of 10.
Wow.
That's some brutal stuff. But they, yeah, I was like, wow, that's, yeah, maybe you don't want to see it.
Now, I'm just going to wait till one boring night and I'll just pop it on.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but I don't really listen to what those guys say.
You know, I'm the same way. I'm the same way on that.
Because they really put down the Batman versus Superman.
Mm-hmm.
And I really enjoyed that movie a lot.
So, are you a big Marvel or DC?
DC.
Oh, I'm a huge
Superman fan.
See, I grew up being a huge Batman fan. Love Batman. See, when I grew up, it was Batman, Superman, Captain America, and Spider-Man. That was my core four right there. Love that those four comics back in the day. Oops. Speaking of that, I almost knocked down Captain America.
Yeah, mine was Superman, Captain America, and Flash.
Wow,
I really liked Flash.
Mm-hmm. That's awesome.
And, I used to watch the old shows, Flash.
Mm-hmm.
And the guy that played Flash, he's the father of the new Flash in the Netflix show.
The TV show? Look, I just choked every second. The TV on the CW?
Yeah.
Yeah, I love that show.
It's on Netflix, so I thought it was a Netflix series.
That's right, yeah. I forgot they'd already put that on there. So I knew Arrow was on there already. Mm-hmm. And Daredevil is great on Netflix, if you haven't seen that yet.
I have not finished just so many TV shows.
Oh, gosh, I'm the same way. Yeah, people keep saying, you need to check this out. Like, dude, I've got too much as it is. My plate is full on TV right now.
With work and all these TV shows, sometimes you come home from work, you just don't want to do nothing.
Yeah. Well, I don't know if you're like me. You reach that age where you turn something on, and it's like my grandma used to. She just falls asleep in front of the TV.
Yeah.
And I started doing that. I was like, gosh, I'm getting old when I'm starting to fall asleep in front of the TV. Yeah, man. And then people say, so what'd you think of? I was like, I'm not sure. I have to check it out again. Is there any good movies coming out anytime soon as far as horror goes? Because I never hear about anything.
There are a few.
Mm-hmm.
I can't think of their names, but mm-hmm. let me see. There's been a few that already came out, like The Boy, the Forest.
Mm-hmm.
And I've heard really bad things about that movie. I have not watched them yet. They are coming out with a Strangers Part 2.
Really?
Yeah.
That was a good movie.
Yeah, and I can't wait for that. I think that's coming out at the end of 2016.
Hmm.
And I did hear rumors that there's going to be a movie called Death House.
Mm-hmm.
With a bunch of, like, iconic horror figures. Like Pinhead, Jason, Freddy, like all in one house and just battling on.
Because I had this vision of these guys kind of like in a real world situation. Like that old TV show. That would actually be a great comedy. What happens when horror legends quit being killing people and start being real? That would be hilarious.
That would be fun to watch.
We need to make this happen. Man, that would be awesome. Wow. See, what other movies, TV, what else?
Let's see. TV, I'm not exactly sure what's on TV. Yeah. But
see, like I'm Netflix, to I watch that more.
On a lot of horror movies.
Mm-hmm.
And I've been watching a lot of reviews from Joe. I don't know if you know his YouTube channel.
Uh-uh.
Joe Manganiello.
Mm-hmm. I'll check that out.
He does a lot of horror reviews. And, Deathgasm. That was a good movie. I did see Deathgasm.
I've never heard of that one.
I don't know if you have seen that.
I have not even heard of that.
It's an awesome movie. I get the Box of Dread.
Yeah.
It's a it's kind of like it's horror block, but a lot better.
Mm-hmm.
And that was the time that Deathgasm was coming out. You know, in a Box of Dread, it had like posters, books, and it's about like heavy metal, demons, the devil. There's a lot of gore. Like gore, zombies. It's an awesome movie. I do recommend it. It's horror and it's comedy. You know, so it's wicked awesome.
Yeah, I'm looking at the poster on it. The poster looks awesome.
Yeah.
That is all just an amazing looking poster. It's like almost like a Satan figure way in the back. It's got like one guy in the front with a heavy metal guitar. It's a girl on one side, and it looks like a, is it a guy on the other side with a chainsaw?
Yes.
That looks phenomenal. I'm definitely going to check that out. I wonder if it's on Netflix.
I watched it for free online. I'm not sure which website it was, but I just Googled it.
Mm-hmm.
And I found it.
I'd definitely go check that out.
I think Amazon does sell the DVD.
Mm-hmm.
As well.
Let me see. Rental on iTunes. I don't ever rent any movies. I feel like I'm wasting my money if I rent them. Then again,
yeah, if it's a good price,
yeah,
like $2, fine. But
yeah, I'm sorry, what? No, go ahead.
I have Amazon Prime.
Mm-hmm.
So I watch a lot of my movies that way.
And then, do they have a lot of, like, newer movies?
On Amazon Prime, yes. Some of them are really bad.
Mm-hmm.
There's like Screambox.
Mm-hmm.
That's, I think it's $4 a month. Or you can pay for the whole year. And it's like Netflix, but all horror.
That's pretty cool. I had not heard of that one.
It's nice, but you're not going to find any like main horror movies like Nightmare on Elm Street. No, like you're not going to find any of those.
Hmm.
There's like a lot of low budget films, a lot of B-rated movies, a lot of some 80s movies. So it's really, really, really cool. I haven't been on it in a while because of work.
Yeah.
But that's usually what I watch.
Yeah. Well, tell you what, work does get in the way of a lot of stuff.
Yeah, it does.
Man, gosh. Yeah, I was trying to think of more horror movies that I liked when I was a kid, and I can't think of them all. Then growing up, there were so many of them I used to watch. And I know that. Go ahead.
With horror, they came out in I think it's a Steelbook, the Texas Chainsaw America Texas Chainsaw Massacre Part 2.
Mm-hmm.
And they came out with the Blu-ray Steelbook.
Yeah.
And it has tons and tons of like extra features.
Now, is this from the original ones or the?
The original ones, yeah.
I know Jessica Biel's in one of them, I believe.
That's one of the more recent ones, right?
Yeah.
Part two had that Hopper guy.
Dennis Hopper?
Dennis Hopper. And it also has. See, I'm bad with names.
Mm-hmm.
The guy in the Rob Zombie movies. He was not the Devil's Rejects, yeah. House of a Thousand Corpses.
I know who you're talking about, and I cannot think of his name for save my life.
Yeah,
big dude, bald head with a goatee beard type.
Yep.
Yeah, gosh, I can't think of his name.
Well, he had hair in the. It wasn't a clown.
That was not him?
No, it was I think it was the brother of the House of a Thousand Corpses.
Mm-hmm.
He's the one that got the cheerleader's father's face on his face.
Yeah.
He's got that long, dirty, white, blondish hair.
Is he like a skinny guy?
Skinny guy, yeah.
Yeah, I know you're talking about, yeah. Now, that guy, I have no idea what his name is.
Yeah, I mean, I'm bad with names. I always forget.
Yeah, that's one thing. I know a lot of people, they go, well, that's directed by this person. I'm like, that means nothing to me.
Yeah, it's like, what? No.
I mean, there's a few directors that I could kind of go, okay, I know who that is. But for the most part, I'm like, dude, I have no idea. And some of my friends, they go, you know, this guy directed that, and that. And I'm like, you know that? I'm glad you know that, because I didn't know that.
Yeah, it's very hard to remember all their names.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it's just, I did get Sleepaway Camp. I think that came out in the 80s.
Sleepaway Camp.
It's an old horror movie. I just got that today from Amazon. It's a Blu-ray. And I also got... what did I get? I think it was Prom Night.
Mm-hmm.
With,
I do remember that name? Back in the day.
Keep forgetting her name. She was in Halloween.
The original one, Jamie Lee Curtis?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I just found out that Jamie Lee Curtis's mom was in the original Psycho movie.
Was that was Vivian Leigh, wasn't it? Or no, no, yeah. No. Was that who it was?
It was the girl in the shower.
Yeah. Was that Vivian Leigh? That don't sound right to me. I know who you're talking about, but for some reason that does not sound right to me. Let me see. I'm looking up Sleepaway Camp right now because I know I saw that back in the day. You know what? I'm skipping that and going to Psycho. You know what? It's Psycho. I do want to ask you about that. You remember the remake with Vince Vaughn?
Yes. Yep.
What did you think about that?
They could have done a better job. I'm a fan of Psycho. You know, I read the book by Robert Bloch.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's one of the... That's the only book where I probably read about 5-6 times.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and so I wanted to watch all the Psycho movies.
Yeah.
But the one with Vince Vaughn... no, because like, I see Vince Vaughn, I see the funny guy.
Yeah. You know? I mean, I saw him playing... Well, to me, he plays the same character in every movie.
Yeah,
and I saw that same character like, dude, you're bad. That's horrible.
Exactly.
I mean, I made it like 30 minutes into it, and I was like, I can't watch it anymore.
I mean, I seen the whole movie, and
yeah. The
actress that was in that movie, she was good.
Anne Heche.
I have no idea. I mean, I haven't seen her in a lot of movies.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but she's done an amazing job.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but yeah, it was just a horrible movie.
Yeah, I totally agree. Yeah. I thought that was bad. By the way, it was Janet Leigh, not Vivian Leigh. Janet Leigh.
Ah.
I knew Vivian didn't sound right, but I thought, well, maybe that's who it was. But the Vince Vaughn was like, it felt like they were just, when they said remake, they made it. It felt like exactly like the original. And
yep.
And that's why I think they failed really bad with it.
Yeah, I mean, it's...
Because Anthony Perkins was amazing in that first one.
Mm. The first one, I think there was 4, right?
Well, I'm talking about, you know, the very first original one way back in the day. Was it that many?
I believe so. I think...
it was at least 2.
I think 1 and 2 were the best ones. And I think part 3 is when it started to die. Which was horrible.
Mm-hmm.
But I think it was either 3 or 4 movies that they came out. I'm not really sure.
Let's see. Psycho franchise. Oh, wow. It was 4 of them.
Yeah.
Let's see. Yeah, Psycho in 1960. Psycho 2 in 1983. Wow, 23-year gap. That's a long time.
Yes.
Psycho 3 was 86 and Psycho 4 was 90. Wow. I've often said if you make a remake, you have like 10 years at the most to do a sequel to something. Have you watched the Dumb and Dumber? When they tried that new one, it was horrible.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know what Hollywood's thinking.
Yeah.
Or, you know, it's just that remakes, they don't work.
Yeah.
You know, it's... I mean, I would really like to see a remake of Psycho again, just because I think the one with Vince Vaughn, you know, the Psycho fans, we need a better remake.
Mm-hmm.
You know, in the show, Bates Motel.
Yeah.
That actor, he does an amazing job.
Yeah, I think he does a real good job, too. Is that still going?
I believe so. I watched every episode on Netflix.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just waiting for them to add more on Netflix. That could be like a year or so.
Yeah.
You know?
That's my biggest problem. I can't really sit week to week and waiting for stuff. I need that binge like they have on Netflix.
Yep.
And I love that.
I mean, I think I'm going to have to buy a TV.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because I'm missing out on a lot. And I don't even have a Blu-ray DVD player.
Oh, you need to upgrade.
I need to upgrade bad.
Uh-huh. But, you know? But the good thing is they're pretty cheap now.
Yeah, I see one for about $60.
Yeah.
Not bad at all.
Yeah. And so, and a lot of them now you can get that has internet, so you can watch like WWE and stuff, like your Netflix and stuff on TV too, so.
Yeah, I have seen those smart TVs,
mm-hmm.
and they have the Bluetooth with the smart feature in there.
Yeah.
I mean, that's actually pretty cool.
Yeah. Like with mine, I just run mine through my Xbox and watch everything like that. But you don't want to get an Xbox. They cost too much.
Yeah.
It's about like the Xbox One and the PlayStation 4. I think they're about $300-$400 a piece right now. It's too expensive for them.
I used to have a PS4.
Ah. Past tense.
I'm not big into gaming.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe it's because I'm a sore loser. Like, I don't like to lose, you know, so I get angry, I toss the remote, it breaks, so I'm like, I can't do this.
Yeah, I told somebody one time, I was like, you know, people have that walk of shame. My walk of shame is after I've broken a controller, walk into the GameStop and buy a new controller. I have broken a few of them. Now, I will say my recent one I've had for a long time. But I have cut back on some of my games.
Now, I have done. I brought the PS4 back,
mm-hmm.
and I traded it in for a Wii U.
Uh huh.
And people were shocked. I'm like, you what?
Yeah.
I'm like, yeah, I just want the Wii U. I want to play just Mario Brothers.
Yep.
And that's all I play now. And there's that new Mario Maker.
Mm-hmm.
You can make your own levels. Like, I'm an 80s gamer, you know. Pac-Man, Mario Brothers, Frogger.
Now, Donkey Kong is one of my all-time favorites.
Yes.
I love Donkey Kong. And I have the Wii. And I should have went ahead and just bought... you can buy Donkey Kong right through the system, and I never did do it. I don't know why. I should have. I didn't.
Huh.
And...
I did not know that you could do that.
Yeah. I assume it's like that on Wii U. You just buy the game right through it, through the system.
Oh.
I assume
I'll have to check that out.
It should have like a app store on through the system.
There's one of the things on my wish list is to buy the actual arcade game.
Uh-huh.
You know, but they go for like over $1,000. And I want one with, you know, like Pac-Man and like other games. Like,
yeah.
I think it was the 4-screen one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's someday I will buy one of those.
All right. When you were younger in the 80s, did you go into, around here we had Pizza Hut and they had the tabletop version of the games.
Mm.
You go up to it and you sit down and it's like the screens of the table.
Yep.
And you throw your coin. Throw your quarters in and play that way. I've seen some of those online, and it had like 50 or 60 games in it. And I was like, bad. I mean, it's a grand, which is not good, $1,000 for it. But I was like, man, some of those games I would love to play again.
It, you know, it's a lot of money, but it brings back memories.
Mm-hmm.
And it will really look good in your house.
Yeah.
You know?
See, now, I would rather have, like, the upright version as opposed to the tabletop version.
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
Now, I don't know how much, like, I don't know how much the upright version would be like that, but, like I said, that they had that tabletop. I was like, that looks really cool. And I always thought having a pinball game in the house would be awesome, too.
Mm.
Except it'd be making too much noise.
Yeah.
Like, I have my own little arcade in my house. That'd be great.
That'd be awesome. Like, I mean, people come over.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like if you have like any WrestleMania nights.
Yeah.
You know, have the guys come over, drinks. You know, drink some beer, play some arcade, watch WrestleMania, or even the Super Bowl.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's just, you know, it could be an awesome time.
That would be great. I just need to win the lottery and get a bigger house for all that.
Yeah.
Have that and all my toys and everything, too.
Yeah, that's a big problem with these Funko Pops. They mm-hmm. just take way too much space.
Yeah, well, I got those. I got all my action figures, and I got comic books on top of that, too. So space is, wow. It started out for me as like one toy room, like that's gonna be it. I have one like 6 foot table, like that's all I'm gonna need. It slowly spread into my what used to be my guest room, but my cousin, I don't know my cousin, but my sister-in-law, they needed the bed for my niece's son. So I was like, yeah, you can have the bed, and that's become toy room part two. Like, darn, I had a nice guest room, now I have a second toy room. Man, I'll tell you what, they build up a lot faster than you would think.
Yeah, and like Mezco, mm-hmm. they're coming out with a lot of great items, tons of awesome figures.
Mm-hmm.
And I already pre-ordered a lot of them.
Mm-hmm.
And I need to make room for them. I think it's it's like 3 or 4 new Chuckies.
Wow.
There's one, it's a 5-inch, and it comes with a knife and a gun.
Mm-hmm.
And they also come with extra hands.
Mm-hmm.
They're coming out with a new, like, good guy doll.
Yeah.
You know? And it does talk. It's about, like, 15 inches tall.
Wow, that's a big one there.
Yeah. And it's awesome because you look at them like, that's going to be expensive.
Yeah.
But it's only $94.
That's not bad at all.
Yeah. And the 5-inch Chucky with the knife and gun is like, I think it's $20.
Wow. That's yeah. That's cheap.
Right. And also coming out with the bride from Bride of Chucky.
Mm-hmm.
You know. And they're coming out with a mask. I mean, I don't know why they're doing that, but it's a Chucky mask. From Bride of Chucky, it's mm-hmm. half face, it's plastic mask, but mm-hmm. I do want that, you know, because anything Chucky, I'm going to get it.
Yeah, that's a small mask? Because I think if it felt like little Chucky, that'd be like a small little mask.
Oh, yeah, it's like it might not even fit my face,
mm-hmm.
but the way they package it.
Mm-hmm.
They package it in a way that you can just, you know, put it on your wall.
Mm-hmm.
It'll just be an awesome item to own.
See, you're like that. And me, it's Harley Quinn. I love Harley Quinn. Just love that character.
Mm.
And that's why I'm kind of dreading Suicide Squad, because I don't think they will have Harley Quinn the way she should really be from the last 20 years of Harley Quinn.
Yeah, I don't know who's, like, how they find these actresses and actors to play mm-hmm. these characters.
But I think she's a good actress. I think she can do well, but the voice she's using, it doesn't fit the character. But when she was in Wolf of Wall Street, that voice she had used in that, I thought would have been perfect. And she's not using that same voice, and I don't know why.
I had no idea that she was in Wolf of Wall Street.
Yeah. You seen that with Leonardo DiCaprio?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's the blonde. Yeah, his girlfriend, wife.
All right.
She's not ugly.
She's
not ugly at all. That's this joke we always say when you see a woman, she's really gorgeous. You just go, she's not ugly. She's not ugly at all. So if you listen to some of our podcasts, we talk about a woman, you go, she's not ugly. You know, you mean she's gorgeous.
I hope she pulls it off.
Yeah, me too.
You know, I mean, she does. She definitely has the body mm-hmm. of Harley Quinn.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's just that I need to see her in action, fighting.
Yeah.
You know? And I don't know if you've seen the newest trailer yet.
I did see the newest trailer. The one from the MTV Awards the other night.
Yes.
I did see that one. And, you know, one thing that does worry me, they said they just got them all back for to reshoot some scenes. And what I've heard is they are trying to take some of the darkness out of it and maybe add a little more comedy to it. And then people are saying that's because of Batman Superman, how dark and gritty that was. And yeah, they want to, like, kind of almost distance themselves a little bit from that and bring a little more comedy to it. I don't like that idea at all.
You know, you have to keep it dark.
Yeah.
You know, it's supposed to be an action movie.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, you could have some comedy, but, like, don't overdo it with the comedy.
Yeah, I mean, Harley, she is a funny character. But some of these other guys, they are not funny characters. And kind of work with what they have with that. And exactly. I don't know if they're trying to say, you know what, Marvel's got this comedy thing and it's working really well, so let's try to go that way a little bit too. But I don't like them doing that.
No, that's... Yeah, I do agree with you. That's... Mm-hmm. I don't like that either.
But, you know, I can't wait to see it. I'll say that. And Civil War coming up next month. I'm excited about that.
That's Civil War. That's in May 6th, right?
5th or 6th, I think. I think it's 5th, actually, I believe. And then, like, the 19th or 26th, something like that, is X-Men Apocalypse. Mm. And honestly, that one does not look very good to me.
No?
And one of my best friends, he loves Marvel. He's like, I'm not looking forward to that one at all, which is shocking to me.
Yeah, it's going to be one hell of a year for movies.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's we hardly get anything like this. You know, like, one year jam-packed with all these awesome movies. It's just, you know, and it started with, what, Deadpool?
Mm-hmm, yep.
Which I cannot wait for that to come out on DVD.
Mm-hmm.
And it's you know, it's weird. It seems like movies come out on DVD a lot quicker now.
Yeah, yeah. Like Star Wars just come out, and I didn't expect that for about another month or two.
Yep.
I figured that'd be, you know, like almost like a summer release just on DVD Blu-ray. How long is it going to be before Deadpool comes out on Blu-ray? Or you heard that yet? Because I haven't even heard.
I don't know, because it should come out soon, I hope, because I know Amazon is coming out with an exclusive Batman versus Superman Blu-ray that comes with the figure.
Really?
And I think it's going to be over $100. So it's either you choose the Batman or the Superman. And it's like something that you can, like, display.
Dang, that's a lot of money for that.
I don't know if it's from, like, Mezco or from, like, Hot Toys, but
see, Hot Toys looks would be like worth
a Mezco figure.
Or that or Play Arts, because Play Arts has really good figures as well. I did not hear. I'm gonna have to check that out because I didn't hear anything about that.
Yeah, I think that comes out July 16th.
Really? Yeah. I'll definitely be looking that up. They should see July. Well, I was going to say they probably had a pre-order, but probably not quite yet.
No.
You know, I know I'm going all over the place, but horror movie. Have you seen Sinister?
Sinister.
With Ethan Hawke. It's about a crime writer, and he finds some old reel-to-reel video. And, like, the criminal, it's like a spirit or something comes through the videos and starts killing people.
Oh, no, I haven't watched that yet, no.
Oh, man. I want to know what you thought on that, John. Check that out and let me know what you think.
Sinister, yeah.
Sinister.
I'm going to have to write that down so I don't forget.
Yeah, I mean, like I said, I thought that was one of those movies I thought was really, really good.
Is that on Netflix?
That I do not know. It's just one I remember seeing a while back. You know what? Well, I don't have Netflix right in front of me. If I did, I would check it out.
Awesome.
Mm-hmm.
I will check that out. I did see...
You know what? It's technically not considered a horror. On this, it says a thriller mystery, but it's got some good horror in it. At least for me. I mean, it doesn't have that straight up blood and gore. It's kind of like more psychological stuff.
Oh, I see, yeah.
So I enjoyed it greatly. Let's see. I just noticed you have the Elm Street, like the street sign back there.
Yes.
I just saw that. That's very cool.
That's from Ruby Songbird.
Mm-hmm.
She like amazing artist.
That's awesome. Also, that's like a little painting.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was like an actual like street sign thing.
It's like a little canvas.
Mm-hmm.
Like it's on the wood.
Yeah.
That
is awesome. Because I just thought it'd be like one of those like metal street plates is what I actually thought it was. That is awesome.
I was looking for those.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, at one point I was thinking like maybe I should just take my own street sign down.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not going to do that because I might get into a lot of trouble because I actually do live on Elm Street.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, in Roanoke, there's a comic book shop on Elm Street.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, but they don't call it Nightmare. They call it B&D. It's like, come on. You have the name right there.
Right?
Nightmare Comics or something like that. Nightmare Comics on Elm Street. I think that would have been awesome.
Oh, definitely.
I mean, if I'm on Elm Street, that's what I'm naming it. I don't care what kind of business it is. It's going to be called Nightmare. Convenience store. Nightmare Convenience. I mean, come on. That just sets you up for an easy name.
I mean, when I first moved into Elm Street, I didn't really care what the place looked like. I just wanted to live on Elm Street.
What was the number that Freddie lived at? Gosh,
I think it was a 4-digit number. I'm not sure. That's an interesting question.
What kind of a horror fan are you not knowing that? Let me see if I can find that. Freddy Krueger. Address. 1428 Elm Street.
Awesome.
You know, this is one thing I think is awesome, is that, you know, basically in the palm of my hand, my cell phone is basically a computer. I love that. I think I heard one time that an iPhone could basically, what year was it? Back when they sent the first people to the moon. I think there's almost as much power in a cell phone now as it was to actually send that ship to the moon.
Oh, wow.
As computer power. I was like, that's insane.
It's crazy what you can do now with cell phones.
Yeah.
You know, like, when I first started my YouTube videos, I used my cell phone.
That's actually what I use for mine.
Yeah, see? So I actually used my cell phone, and I uploaded it on my cell phone.
Mm-hmm.
Everything was just this little thing.
Yeah.
It's like, that's insane.
Yeah.
You know, my first cell phone was like a Nextel.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
I remember my first one was the old flip top. The old clamshell flip top.
Yeah, my parents, they still use that.
Oh, and my mom does
trying
too.
Trying to teach them how to use an iPhone. Not gonna happen.
Yeah, that's how my mom is. Hers broke a couple years ago, and I told her, let's just upgrade to a new phone. She's like, I like this one. Yeah. And the thing of it is, those phones are expensive. You would think this old thing with no power in it. Now, the great thing about those phones, the battery lasts forever.
Oh, it does, yeah.
I mean, because there's no computer working in it. I mean, I ask her how often she charges. She's like, about every 3 or 4 days. Like, great day. I have to charge mine every day.
Exactly.
Wow.
So, what else? Anything else?
I know, because I've been looking at, I'm on Mesco almost every day.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they are coming out with a new Hellraiser.
Oh, really?
A awesome looking pinhead. I don't know how tall he is, but I think he's about 12 inches tall.
Mm-hmm.
And it comes with all the weapons. Comes with this little, what do you call it? The puzzle box?
I like that cube.
Yeah.
Yeah. I can't remember the name of it, but I remember the cube, yeah.
You know, it looks amazing.
Yeah. That does look so sweet.
I think they're asking like $94 for that.
Gosh.
Man. And it looks like something that is worth more.
Yeah, that's one of those things. I'm going to have to win the lottery because there's so much stuff I want, and I just can't get it all. It stinks.
And the thing with Mesco is when they come out with these horror figures, they go on sale. Then once it's sold out.
That's it?
That's it.
Mm-hmm.
No, you have to buy them on eBay for more.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a part that sucks. If you miss it, man, it stinks trying to find it later. It's like me with a couple of comic books I'm trying to find. It's like, good gracious. There was one called Detective Comics 880, and it's the Joker's face on it, but it's basically made out of Batman's bats. And you see the bats, like, obviously kind of floating out. And I could have gotten it at the comic book shop for, I think it was $3.99. And last time I looked online, it was up to, it's going around 80 to 100.
Like,
now that, it came out 2011, I think. It's like, this is ridiculous. As soon as I want it, it goes up.
2011, and it's already that much.
Yeah. And it's the only reason I believe it is just for that cover, because the cover looks absolutely amazing.
Mm.
And the first appearance of Harley Quinn, that was in 93, I believe. And last year I was thinking about buying it, and it was about $300. It's like, good gracious, that's crazy. Last time I looked at the show, it was about $800 to $900.
Wow.
I was like, in a year it went up that much? And it's all because of the movie coming out.
You know, that's one thing I get worried about a lot with the Funko Pops is the value.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm afraid that one day Funko Pops will just die.
Go the way of the Beanie Babies.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And then, like, all of a sudden we have a bunch of Pops that, all right, they're cool, but how long are we going to hold on to these Funko Pops? And it's like, there are some that I would like to just sell or trade,
mm-hmm.
you know, but I'm just afraid that they're not going to be as popular, you know, in the next 10 years or so.
Yeah. Well, that's the big thing with collectibles. You know, they have their cycle. And yeah, that's something I've been thinking about for a while too. I mean, like, value to me doesn't really matter because I get them just because I like them.
Right.
But I would like for them to have value. I think, like, for me, I think it's more mental. It's like, does it have value? It does? Okay, then I'm glad I have it. It doesn't have any value? Man, why have I got that? And I go, oh, because I think it's cool. That's why.
Like, exactly. I mean, I would like it, you know, to be worth something so I can keep, you know, like, and pass it on.
Yeah.
You know, like, if I ever do have any kids, they can pass it on. You know, because, like, I mean, I'm not going to sell it.
Yeah.
I'm just going to, like, you know, pass it on to your kids, and your kids, it'll be something very rare, you know, and you can have, you know, awesome conversations about this item, you know?
Yeah.
But, I mean, horror figures, I don't think they'll ever go out of style.
Yeah.
You know, because, like, some of them are very hard to find. And, man, I just got, well, I didn't just get it. It was, like, a few weeks ago from NECA Toys, Pamela Voorhees.
Yeah.
with Little Jason.
Oh, with Little Jason?
Yeah.
I have not seen that. I mean, is it like when at the end when he come out of the lake, was all kind of like torn up and stuff?
His face is all messed up.
Yeah.
And he's wearing the Camp Crystal Lake shirt and the swim shorts.
Mm-hmm.
And it's an amazing, it's awesome. It's so expensive.
Mm-hmm.
But I just had to do it. I think I got it for, I think it was $140, I think.
Wow. So I've never even seen that one. And she had like like that turtleneck.
Are you talking about Pamela?
Yeah. Did she have like that turtleneck? And so I remember that last scene and then her head getting chopped off.
The head, yeah. It was a bluish turtleneck, yeah.
Yeah, it's funny to me how that movie is really different from all the rest of them.
Yep.
Because, you know, she was the killer in that first one. And then, you know, after that, it was him and all of them. That to me is really an interesting twist. Because most people are like, no, it's always been Jason. No, it wasn't.
Yeah, when somebody tells me I really like the first Jason movie, you know, he was awesome. Like, what are you talking about?
Mm-hmm.
You know, she was awesome. You know?
Now, what'd you think about Jason X?
In space?
Yeah.
I did not like that at all.
I think it was one of the worst movies. But there was one scene. You remember when he kind of got transformed in it?
Yeah.
And we always said he kind of looks like, you remember the movie The Mighty Ducks?
The Mighty Ducks, yeah.
It was like, he kind of looked like Jason meat kind of blends with the Mighty Duck logo. And then that scene at the end where he's floating back toward the spaceship and the one guy comes right across and takes him out. I was like, that was so funny and so cheesy.
I don't know who wrote that.
Mm-hmm.
That was just the worst that you could ever do.
And
why would Jason be in space?
he was frozen and then kind of got a cryo storage. It's like, what in the world? Then he kills everybody that got him out of cryo storage. It's so stupid.
And it's the same with Leprechaun in space.
I did not see that. I remember Leprechaun in the Hood.
That movie, it was a bit cheesy, but it was funny.
What, in space?
No, the Leprechaun in the Hood.
Yeah, I bought both of them. There's two of them.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Leprechaun in the Hood. Leprechaun, I think it's Back to the Hood, I believe is what it's called.
Oh.
I saw that, a long time ago in the Walmart $5 bin. I was like, dude, I've got to get those. The Rapping Leprechaun.
The one in space...
Hmm?
I don't remember it because I never finished the movie.
Mm-hmm.
It's one of those movies that it's going to, you know, you're bored.
Yeah.
So I'll just stop watching it and I'll watch the rest later.
Yeah.
But you never do.
Oh, gosh, there's been so many like that for me. There's been a ton of them. Wow. Leprechaun in space. Oh, Jason Takes Manhattan. I tell you, one of the funniest scenes in that movie, where he was chasing the guy in Manhattan. The guy, I can't remember what the guy's name is, but he runs into a building, and he kind of looks back and he sees Jason coming, and Jason walks in the door, and almost immediately the guy's getting thrown out of the second floor.
Yeah. Like,
how did he get up there that quick? I was like, what just happened?
Hey, Jason doesn't run. He walks really slow. You can run a mile and open the door, and boom, there he is.
It kind of reminded me of the old Pepe Le Pew cartoon. Like, there's Pepe chasing the cat that somehow or another walked under something, got paint on her back. Now she looks like a skunk, too.
Yeah.
And she's taking off running, he's just slowly prancing along. Yeah, there we go. I just compared Jason to Pepe Le Pew.
Yeah, you did.
Wow. I'm sure that's not been hadn't happened too often. Dang. So, anything else?
I am excited for one movie.
Mm-hmm.
It's the new Child's Play movie.
Oh, there's another one coming out?
Yeah.
I did not know that.
I did not like the last one.
How many are we up to now? Last time I remember, it was like 6.
I think the new one is 7.
Is it? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Chucky 7.
Okay.
I think they're going to call it Chucky 7.
Mm-hmm.
In the last Chucky movie, he did not look like Chucky at all.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he looked weird. I mean, I watched the whole movie, but I was disappointed. But they are making a new Child's Play movie. I'm not exactly sure when that's coming out.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know if they're even, you know, in the middle of filming the movie. But, yeah, that's going to be coming out soon. I'm hoping either this year or next year. Hoping. But, yeah.
Yeah, I'm looking up to see how many they've had now. I knew it was a bunch of them. I didn't. Let's see. Child's Play franchise. Let's see.
I have the whole DVD. I'm just going to go grab it real quick.
Mm-hmm. So I see up to 7 right there. Let's see. 7 was up to 2004, I believe.
Mm. Yeah, so 6.
There's nothing on mine. It says 7 on this really? List here. Uh-huh. And the 7th one came out in 2004, according to this. But written by Don Mancini. Let me IMDb to see how that is.
I think Don Mancini is the original Child's Play writer.
It says he wrote all of them.
Yeah. But, I mean, I do have the box set here.
Mm-hmm.
And it does come with the regular Child's Play.
Oh, that one did?
Yeah.
Because the ones I saw was, like I say, in Best Buy. And it was kind of like in a clear plastic. And it started with number 2.
Mm. Yeah, see, this one has Child's Play, Child's Play 2, Child's Play 3, Bride of Chucky, Seed of Chucky, and Curse of Chucky.
Let's see. Oh, wrong button. Child's Play. Yeah. That didn't even say.
No?
I don't know. Maybe there was only 6, but it said 7 on that one thing under on Google. Yeah, but what is Google now?
Yeah, there's no years on this box set either. It just shows Child's Play in 1988.
Mm-hmm.
And it just shows that this came out in 2013, the box set.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I think Part 7 is going to be the newest movie out. And it's going to be, hopefully, better than The Curse of Chucky.
See, I know I saw up to 3 or 4. I can't remember which one of the last one was. I think. Wait. 3 was The Bride of Chucky.
3 was when he was looking for Andy, mm-hmm. and Andy was in that army school or something.
Yeah.
The boot camp school.
Mm-hmm.
And I think Part 4 is when there was no more Andy.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Which one was actually called Bride of Chucky?
Bride of Chucky, that's Part 4.
Part 4? Okay, then. Yeah. That, I think that was the last one I saw. Wow. Man, that's been a long time ago. Mm. Might have to check and see if they're on Netflix.
I checked.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Really?
Nope.
Wow. Well, that's not cool.
Because I used to have the original VHS.
Mm-hmm.
But a few years ago, I decided to sell all my VHSs.
Mm-hmm.
And I wish I never did. Because there was a lot of great movies that I wish I still kept.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
I was like that with some of my, well, not sold them, but some of my comics. When we moved from one place to another, it was like, I'm not looking at these anymore. And we just trashed a bunch of them. Oh. Oh. Looking back, it's like, what was I thinking? But little did I know then that comic books would have that resurgence like they are now. You know, back then, I would have never thought that it would have a year like this with, what, 5 or 6 different movies coming out? Would have never thought that.
No. That's... I was never huge into comic books. But when I was a kid, I did have a few. But I never, you know, took care of them.
Mm-hmm.
I would read and then they just end up on the floor to get ruined.
Mm-hmm.
You know? But then I just recently got into comic books when I got a horror comic. And then that's when I found out that they had Child's Play comics.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And Jason Voorhees comics and Freddy. I'm like, oh man. You know, like I have to dig into my wallet now. I need all these comics.
Yep. Oh man, they if it's out there, they'll make a comic of it.
Oh yeah.
I mean, it's everything. It's like the pop vinyls. If it's something out there, that they will have a find a way to be a pop vinyl of it.
No, speaking of Funko, when they came out with the reaction figures,
mm-hmm.
The horror reaction figures, there was no Chucky.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't even think about that. Yeah.
And when I went on eBay, I see one that looks like a reaction figure. But it was all in Japanese.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, I don't know if it was just for them, but it's very strange.
I did not even know that. Let me ask you this, because I know you have a bunch of those Freddy Krueger, now the NECA figures.
Some are by NECA, some are McFarlane and Mezco.
Yeah. Because I know you bought a bunch of them. I watched your video the other day. And, like, one of them you had in the tuxedo. Yeah. And, gosh, what were the other ones?
There was the new ones from the guy. I don't know his name. It was not Robert Englund.
Yeah, the guy that played Rorschach in The Watchmen.
Yes.
Yeah, I know you're talking about. I can't. Gosh, another guy's name I can't think of. Yeah.
I have his figure, and I also have his figure as just a human.
Mm-hmm.
And I have
that's one I've never seen either. When he was just a regular human, I never saw that one.
It looks awesome. I mean, it's not something that I would buy.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm always on eBay. I'm always looking for deals. I'm always, you know, asking for like, hey, I'll pay this, you know.
Yeah.
And I think, how much did I pay for that whole box? I think it was $190.
Mm-hmm. How many was in that one? Because I remember watching that video. I was like, man, I don't like those ones you had. I don't think I ever saw any of them.
Yeah, I was very lucky because they were like that guy wanted a lot more.
Mm-hmm.
But I was just very lucky.
Now, I tell you, like, a set I saw, it was the Goonies, the action figures.
Mm.
And somebody, it was the whole set, and it was 5 of them in the set, and he wanted $200 for them. I was like, man. I was like, I'll give you $150, and he's like, no, I'll sell them for $200. And he sold them for $200 not long, I mean, like within like a half an hour after that. It's like, wow. I know those things are rare because it's been a long time since I saw them.
Yeah, it's just that people get worried because, you know, they're coming from, like, different homes.
Yeah.
You know, and it might come from a home where they smoke indoors.
Mm-hmm.
And if they smoke indoors, then, like, the plastic is going to be all yellow.
Yeah.
You know, and it's not going to be great. But, I've been lucky so far.
public service announcement. Because you're talking about that. It made me think of the figure you got, the Jason. I believe it was a Jason figure that they sent in bubble mailer.
Yes.
I mean, dude, package the stuff. People, you got to package it properly. Stick it in a bubble mailer? Are you kidding me?
And it's not just any figure. It's an awesome figure.
Yeah.
Worth 50, 60 bucks.
Yeah.
Like, that just tells me that the guy who's selling this has no idea. You know, like, if he was a horror fan, if, you know, it probably wasn't even his.
Yeah.
You know, it was probably given to him. And that right there, that makes me angry, because, like, you know, you pay for it, you wait for it, you know, it just comes, it's all damaged, like, oh.
Yes, I remember you were talking about that, and it hurt me to see.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, again, you see all my collectibles and stuff, and it's like, man. And you see something that, like, if I send someone something, it's going to have, you know, bubble wrap, it's going to have, or peanuts, or something around it to keep it in good shape. And when I hear that, that's like, oh, my goodness. Use some common sense, people.
I mean, when I ship it back.
Mm-hmm.
I don't ship it back in with the envelope. I actually put it in the box.
Yeah.
You know, and I always leave a note. This is how you're supposed to pack these things. You know, I want my full refund. And some people, they'll try to fight it. They won't give it to you.
Yeah.
But eBay's been really good.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I've had no problems. The other big problem was. The Green Goblin.
Mm-hmm.
Was the Chase.
Yeah.
I don't know if you've seen that. It was a YouTube, not, no, it was a Facebook Live video. Mm-hmm. It came in damaged. He put it in a box of, like, tampons. Like, girl tampons or something. And it got damaged.
Put it in a box of tampons.
Yeah.
I mean, who does that? I'm
like, what is this? Then I opened it, I was like, oh my god. Like, really? The Chase Goblin?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's one I've never seen around here anywhere. Never. Any of the shows I've been at, I haven't seen any of them. And it's just like, Walgreens is brutal about that. I mean, you can never find them. Now, I will say this. I did find the unmasked Black Panther the other day.
Oh, nice.
I was pretty happy about that. But one of my friends, he's still looking for, Star Wars figures. Those that set of four that come out last September. Yeah. I have yet to see one that was in any of my local places. Like that glow-in-the-dark Yoda. That's one I wanted. I ended up buying it online.
I was lucky to find it.
Mm-hmm.
And the corner was a little bit damaged.
Mm-hmm.
But I knew if I don't take this, I will never find it.
Yeah.
So I was like, wow. But speaking of shows, I know there's a Comic-Con coming to Boston in a few months.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm actually very excited to go to it'll be my first Comic-Con.
Now, there you go.
It's like, I never actually been to any Comic-Con, but I've seen videos, and there are tons of people. And, like, I don't know how these guys do it.
Is it like a real big show, or is it like a smaller show, or?
Oh, it's huge.
Because I'm trying to think, like, what kind of Comic-Con, because there's one that does, it's almost like a traveling circus. It's called Wizard World. And they have a ton of celebrities there. But the thing that kills me about it is it costs $55 just to walk in the door. And then if you want autographs, they can be anywhere from, I think, like $30 up to like $90 to $100.
Yeah.
Like, that's insane.
I think it was $160 for VIP tickets.
Mm-hmm.
And that's all 3 days, plus you get you know, to go in front of the line.
Mm-hmm.
But still, 160, that's a lot of money.
That's a ton of money.
Because, I mean, if you don't pay that, you're going to be in line forever just to get any autograph.
Well, I mean, that included your autograph price?
No.
Gosh.
I think they sell separate tickets
mm-hmm.
for autographs, and the people who buy tickets are in line first.
Yeah.
For the autographs.
Wow. Man, that's, wow. It's a lot of money. Because, like I said, with the one is like $55 is like, and if I'm not getting autographs or anything, again, so that's another, like say, anywhere from 20 to at least 100. But, yeah. I mean, that's $55 that, now I can't spend it at tables and stuff to buy stuff. I mean, that's, to me, like when I buy stuff on eBay or something, I include in the price in my head shipping. Because that's how much you're paying that money. That counts as how much you're spending on it. So if I buy something at a show, I got to think, if I get a pop vinyl for $10, I really, if that's all I got, that means I paid $65 for that one pop vinyl.
That's true. I mean, I almost bought tickets.
Mm-hmm.
I do want to go, but, I mean, there's going to be so many things there that you want to buy.
Yeah.
That you can't find nowhere else.
Yep.
You know, so, like, I'd rather spend $160 there
mm-hmm.
and bring stuff home, you know, but...
And I would say the best part of it is you see what you're getting. You're touching it. You're looking at it. You know what you're getting. It's not like is it going to be shipped to me properly? Is it going to be in good condition when it gets here? You know what you're getting, and that's a big plus. And plus just walking around, being all around all the other people that collect... And that's also a lot of fun as well. You sit around talking to people. That adds, you know, that's part of the value of it as well.
Mm.
So, I mean, anytime, like I say, I know at least two shows coming up in the next couple months. So I love going to them. Just hanging out, talking to people.
I've been to bike shows.
Mm-hmm.
Bike shows, gun shows. That's really all.
I've never been to a gun show, but... In the last year, one of my friends, she's like a trainer in shooting and stuff. So I got my concealed and carry permit. Well, I haven't actually got the permit yet, but I took the class so I can get one. And it's really the first time I've really been interested in weapons. So I'm like, you know what? I think I will get me a handgun. And she's helped me out and stuff like that. And now I want to go to a gun show. So I've never been.
Gun shows are fun.
Mm-hmm.
The one I go to, they sell a lot of, like, hot sauces, beef jerky.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a lot of old-school guns there.
Mm-hmm.
And, I mean, I'm licensed, and I never bought a weapon at the gun show.
Mm-hmm.
But I always go there for one thing, and that's the hot sauce and the beef jerky. You know, like, that's... I leave there with at least... $30-$40 worth of hot sauce, probably $50 worth of beef jerky. That good.
Now I went to where is it at in Tennessee one time, and they had I guess I just called it the jerky store, and they had like all kinds of different kinds of jerky, mm-hmm. and you know different flavors of it and stuff. It's like this is actually a lot cooler than I thought, because I went in thinking, all right, we gotta have some beef jerky. Oh no. You have like turkey jerky, like venison jerky, and all kinds. I was like, oh, this is interesting. And some, you know, it's different taste, and it's really amazing.
Some are very expensive.
Mm-hmm.
But jerky's awesome.
Mm-hmm.
And there is, around my area, there's it's called Rock and Shock.
Mm-hmm.
It's all horror. And they have, it's in October, so they have a Halloween costume contest.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I've been to it, but at those times, I was there for the music.
Mm-hmm.
And I've always missed it because, you know, it's all heavy metal, and I'm a heavy metal guy.
Mm-hmm.
So I go there, you know. You're drinking, you're in the mosh pit, you're done.
Yeah.
You know, so I always missed it, but this year, there's a lot of people going. So I can't wait to go. And there's one in Texas. A lot of YouTubers are going mm-hmm. to the one in Texas. And I think that's like the bigger one.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because you're going to have Kane Hodder there.
Yeah.
Robert Englund there. You're going to have all these guys there.
For those who don't know, that is Jason and Freddie. Because yep. Some people might not as like Kane Hodder, who's this guy? Is that a musician? No, that was Jason.
So it's like I bought this awesome Jason prop mask,
mm-hmm.
and like I can go to Texas and spend the whole weekend there and get a sign, but not just by one of the guys who play Jason, but probably by two or three.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's awesome.
That is.
You know, and I think it's called Frightmare. Texas mm-hmm. Frightmare.
Mm-hmm.
It's in Texas, and it's Friday, Saturday, and Sunday at a hotel.
Mm-hmm.
And I might go next year because I think it's coming up very soon.
I know they had a big one in Tennessee. I think they have about every year. I don't know what the name of it is. I don't even know when it is, but I just know that they used to have one there.
Yeah, it's you know. I actually like it that it's far away.
Mm-hmm.
Because it gives me a chance to, you know, write it down, plan it, travel, you know?
Yeah.
And, I can't wait for it. I wrote down all my plans. I'm going to have my own little savings, you know? So when I get there, I want to get as much as possible.
Yeah.
I can see, you know? So that's one thing that I cannot wait for.
That sounds awesome.
Yeah.
And one thing great about that, you know, sometimes you just got to get away from home for a little bit.
Yeah.
That's a big thing because, you know, I guess we're probably pretty similar. Like, you know, just getting away. It's hard to do.
It is.
With working and everything, you just won't have much time. And so just, you know, planning something out ahead of time, you know, this is what I'm going to do, save up for it, and have a blast. Like we did, me and my brother, we went to WrestleMania one year. It was in Miami. It's like, man, get out of town. It was great.
Was that WrestleMania 28?
Yep. Once in a lifetime that happened twice the next year.
I was there too.
Were you?
WrestleMania 28. And I only went there because I thought it was The Undertaker's last match.
Yeah.
So I'm like, okay.
You know what? Looking back, it should have been.
I cannot miss this one. I have to go. And me and my buddy, we both got tattoos that with the WWE symbol and 28.
Uh-huh. Where were you at there? I mean, in the stadium.
All right. I don't know what they call it. Is it Loge? If there's a ringside,
uh-huh.
Then the folding chairs, and then the regular seats.
Uh-huh.
So I was like pretty close. You know, I bought the Blu-ray and I watched it at my friend's house, and on almost all the matches, you can spot me.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So, like, it's fun seeing that because, like, mm-hmm. There I am.
No, I'm going to have to watch and see if I can find you.
It's, you can't miss me. It's big guy.
So, you weren't down on the actual floor, were you?
I think I was, eight rows up from the floor.
Mm-hmm. So, like the camera straight back through the ring. Because I was like, if you went straight back through the ring to where the seats are, you know where the actual walkway is?
Yeah.
All right, I was like about four rows down from that. So, I was really close to like that. I mean, not, right. Yeah. So, it was actually, about that. So, I mean, it's like one of those things that if you could really zoom in, you could see me, but otherwise, no.
It was an awesome, awesome day.
The only thing I hate about it is where they had the lights. One of the lights on, like, under that canopy was, like, aimed right at us, and it's kind of hard to see down because of that one light.
Mm.
But they had big screens, so it was good.
I mean, it was my first outdoor wrestling event, you know?
Yeah.
And it's just like, and it's also my first WrestleMania. I was like, wow, this is amazing.
Well, it wasn't our first outdoor event. Way back when we were kids at the local baseball stadium, they used to have like the old NWA wrestling. So, I mean, like Ric Flair and those guys would be wrestling at the local baseball stadium. Yeah, that's back way before it became huge. It's like late 70s, early 80s.
I was actually, my friend has an old NWA wrestling belt.
Oh, really?
He bought it years ago from a wrestling superstore. And now it's worth, I think it's worth like $600. But, you know.
Is it, I mean, like the, like a replica or like an original? Yeah. Is it?
It's like, I think it's 4 feet long.
That's awesome. So I know my brother, gosh, he would love to have something like that. I mean, like those belts seemed like they were so small, but, you know, they strapped around, they looked amazing.
Oh, yeah, because, like, you know, they were big guys.
Yeah.
You know? Now, have you ever met any wrestlers?
Oh, well, back in the day, when they were in the Roanoke Civic Center in Roanoke, Virginia, and, like, between matches, you know, you'd see some of the guys just, like, hanging out in this area. You know, I mean, I was probably not even 10 years old. We could just walk up to them and get autographs. After the events, we could just sit outside and no one cared. People, you know, the guys would come out, sign autographs.
Yeah, here in Boston is a lot different.
Yeah, well, I mean, like I say, this was way back in the day. Nowadays, it's not like that. When we were at WrestleMania, did you go to the Hall of Fame?
No.
Well, that arena is, there's a little like strip mall kind of right beside it. And it's got lots of restaurants, lots of stores and stuff. Ricky Steamboat, he walked by us. Kofi Kingston. And I'll tell you what, he looks small on TV. He's not very small. He's kind of a stout dude. And it's like, man, when you put him beside Big E Langston, he looks small.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I would say he's probably around like 6'2 or something. But, you know, put him beside Big E, all of a sudden he ain't that big.
I've been close to a lot of wrestlers, and it's just amazing. Like Big Show.
Oh, good gracious, yeah.
I never met him, but he walked right by me. And like this was ringside. I forgot what year it was. When that monster walks by you. It's like, wow. It's like, I would not want to wrestle this guy. Now,
and I would say it's in Miami. You know Van Vader?
Van Vader?
Big Van Vader. He was from the 80s and 90s. He was in the room right beside us at the hotel.
Oh, really?
I mean, dude, he's so wide, he actually had to turn sideways to get into the door. I mean, he's a monster. He used to be an offensive lineman for the, was it Los Angeles Rams or were they the St. Louis Rams by then? I think it was still the Los Angeles Rams.
Oh, wow. I had no idea.
Yeah, Leon White. And just a monster of a dude. And the door, you had the little card you slide in and then open the door. These doors were horrible. You had to push it in and it wouldn't open. Push it in, it wouldn't open. I swear I thought he was going to rip the door off the hinges. And me and my brother was like, oh, let us help you. We can help you. And
I don't know how he survived in Japan.
Yeah.
You know, all those small cars and doorways.
Yeah, Big Show, they said that was the biggest problem. Him and Mark Henry, they said that is the biggest problem of travel. He's like, you know, you think it's easy. It's not. Just, you know, being in that plane for hours. And Mark Henry said the biggest problem with that for him is going to the bathroom. He's like, he didn't fit in that little airplane bathroom.
I mean, I'm a big guy.
Mm-hmm.
When I, you know, do fly, I prefer first class because the seats are bigger.
Yeah.
And I have to sit where the armrest on my left side goes up.
Mm-hmm.
Or else it'll be, you know, a very uncomfortable ride, and this side will be all over somebody.
Yeah.
And like, so like, I know the feeling of, I mean, I'm not that as big as those guys. Then going to the bathroom, like, it's a huge pain.
Yeah.
So like, I can't imagine what Big Show or Mark Henry has to go through.
Yeah, he said, when Mark Henry said, man, when they went to Australia, I mean, he said he basically starved himself like the 2 days before, because he didn't want to have to try to go to the bathroom. He's like, what do you mean do? Like, be standing out in the hallway peeing? Because that's basically what he'd have to do. It's like, great day. You know, that's one of the things I never thought about. I mean, like, the seats themselves, I thought about that. But as far as, wow, that's crazy.
I wonder what the Big Show drives.
It'd have to be a huge truck.
Yeah. Like, is these large human beings, like,
mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know, like, they probably need to spend a lot more money on bigger trucks,
mm-hmm.
You know, just to go food shopping.
Yeah. I mean, I know, I know a lot of the guys when they're on tour in the U.S., when they have, like, short stops, and a lot of them have, like, the private buses and stuff. I know John Cena, he's got one, but I think him, maybe Big Show, I think they probably have those in their contract. So they get those things.
I did see a video with Big Show, and he has his own bus.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And I forgot where I seen it, but it showed his bedroom in the bus.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they interviewed the driver. And it's like a huge... you know, it's an apartment on wheels.
Yeah.
You know, it's way better than my apartment.
Yeah.
It's like, wow. You know?
Yeah, I mean, some of those things, it seemed like to me I heard some of them were up in maybe close to six figures in price, like $100,000 or something like that for one of those things. Like, are you kidding me? That's insane. But you know what? When you're that big, you got to have something.
Exactly.
I remember Daniel Bryan was talking about, he's like, he always tried to get the cheapest everything he could. And his wife finally talked him into getting something a little bit more expensive because, like, the small cars and stuff was wearing on his body. So they finally talked him into getting something better. But unfortunately, he can't wrestle anymore.
That's a shame.
Yeah, that is. But, yeah, see, we've been on for, wow. Almost 2 hours, I think.
Oh, wow. Time flies by really fast.
Yeah. So we're going to go ahead and cut it off now. Unless we got anything else.
No, I mean, it's almost about my bedtime. I have to work, I have to be up at 4 in the morning.
Great day. And yeah. I complain about getting up at 6:30. Dang, man. I didn't mean to keep up this late then. All right, man. Your YouTube page is
Jeff Soares,
and I'll put like a little link below so everyone can find you. And I appreciate you being on the show and being patient with my technical difficulties I was having earlier.
That's fine. I mean, it does happen. Yeah. Also, before I do go, I'm doing a 200 subscriber giveaway very soon.
Oh yeah! Congrats on that.
Thank you. I mean, I'm way over 200 now, but I'm just slacking on making that video because I have a giveaway going on right now for that Freddy figure. So I think I'm going to post that video on Friday.
Excellent. I'll definitely be looking for that. And, you know, some of my subscribers, go find Jeff. He's an awesome guy. And I do, like I said, I do appreciate you being on.
Thank you, man. It's lots of fun.
Yeah.
This is my first time being on any podcast.
And one of the things I told somebody else that I had on, I was like, you know, I want to start talking to more people on here because, like, it's a great community. And I would like to, like, get to know a lot more of the people that's in the community as well. And that's why I'm glad I had you on. And, dude, you get to talk about all kinds of stuff.
Awesome, man.
All right, man. And Jeff, thank you very much again. And everyone, y'all have an incredible day.